Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. It's Nursing Ed KJ's Keithian here with another video. And in today's video, we're going to look at how do you become a registered midwife in Canada. Are you a nursing student? Maybe a high school student exploring career options? Perhaps you're a healthcare professional seeking a change? Or you're an internationally educated midwife eager to practice in Canada? Well, welcome. In this video, we're going to dive into the exciting world of midwifery, a rewarding and dynamic profession at the forefront of maternal and newborn healthcare. Whether you're curious about becoming a midwife, or you're considering a career transition, or aiming to practice your skills in Canada, this video will serve as a guide to the schools you need to apply for to begin your initial process of becoming a registered midwife in Canada. I am of the view that as the years progress, the demand for midwives in Canada will no doubt continue to increase. There's a high demand for midwifery services and a shortage of midwives. Currently, there are close to 2,000 midwives practicing across Canada. This number is expected to increase. Now the question is, will you be a part of this number? The outlook for midwives in Canada is a very positive one. As I said, there's a growing demand for their services in many provinces and territories. There's also increased government funding and support, and many mothers are asking that midwives be a part of their healthcare team. Now, the practice of midwifery dates back centuries and is rooted in the profound tradition of caring for women during the transformative journey of pregnancy, childbirth, and the postpartum period. Today, midwives continue this invaluable role as primary care providers for women, extending their expertise to both mothers and newborns. They specialize in supporting normal birth and healthy pregnancies. They address the emotional, physical, spiritual, and cultural dimension of each woman's unique experience. Now let us look at the general overview of your process to become a registered midwife in Canada. You will first need to obtain a Bachelor of Midwifery degree from a recognized midwifery education program. And these programs are offered at universities across Canada. We'll talk more about it. Admission requirements may vary, but generally you will need a high school diploma or equivalent, and some programs may even require specific prerequisite courses. Now, after completing your midwifery education program, you will then need to study so that you can pass the Canadian Midwifery Registration Exam, and it is administered by the Canadian Midwifery Regulators Council, and it will assess your competency in various areas of midwifery practice. Now, once you've passed your CMRE, you can apply for registration with the regulatory body in the province or territory where you wish to practice. Now, each province and territory in Canada has its own regulatory body for midwives, and you'll need to meet their specific requirements for registration, which sometimes will include additional assessments or documentation. Now, in Canada, there are three options to become a midwife. One, complete a direct entry midwifery education program. Two, obtain a degree in nursing or relevant healthcare field, and then pursue additional midwifery training through accelerated programs. Three, complete an internationally educated midwives program if you are trained outside of Canada. There are also community-based programs that are available to Indigenous peoples. So we will now take a look at baccalaureate education that is available in Canada. Baccalaureate level education programs in Canada typically span 3 to 4 years. There are only 6 programs offered in Canada, and there are typically no prerequisite nursing or other credentials needed, but some of the subjects that you might want to think about if it is that you're in high school include your biology, chemistry, math, English, and additional courses that would make you stand out when you're applying. There are 2 universities in Ontario that offer midwifery programs. One of them is the McMaster University, and important to note, this is not open to international students, and it is typically a 4-year program which would span over 9 terms. You would also need to complete an interview if you're one of the successful candidates. Now, the Toronto Metropolitan University, otherwise known as Ryerson, offers a Bachelor of Health Sciences, BHSC, in midwifery. It is a full-time program that will span 4 years. You are also able to complete it part-time over the course of 5 years. The Quebec Midwifery Program is administered at the University of Quebec at Trois-Rivières. This program is offered in French only. There are prerequisites that must be passed by September of the year of admission. You will also need to complete 30 hours of community involvement, and you will have to have these 30 hours completed for the start of the school year in September. This program is reserved for residents of Quebec only. It goes over 3 years and 8 semesters specifically, and you will be able to get $1,000 per internship completed, as well as a $4,000 grant to each student who completes his or her final internship. Manitoba's midwifery program is administered at the University of Manitoba. This Bachelor of Midwifery spans 3 years plus an additional qualifying year. So following a year of undergraduate studies, and this would be your year one, you'll be able to choose to fulfill the Bachelor of Midwifery prerequisites required for admission. The Bachelor of Midwifery is an advanced entry program, which means you must complete at least 1 year of university level education, including several required and recommended courses, before you can be considered for admission. Registration in the Bachelor of Midwifery program is restricted to Canadian citizens, permanent residents, and preference is given to Manitoba residents. Students in the Bachelor of Midwifery program at the University of Manitoba will have to complete the CASPER test, and this is a web-based assessment of interpersonal skills and decision making. And this test will also be considered when they're reviewing your admissions. Additionally, one policy at the University of Manitoba is that students in this program must accept clinical placements in any location in Manitoba arranged for them by the program based on a lottery system. Alberta's midwifery program is administered at Mount Royal University. And in my opinion, Mount Royal University is one of the more flexible programs. Post-secondary applicants, for example, must present a minimum admission grade point average of 2.5. And I think that is very reasonable. Each year, 10% of the seats in the Bachelor of Midwifery program is reserved for Indigenous applicants through an Indigenous admission target. According to the Alberta Association of Midwives, there are 164, approximately, practicing registered midwives in Alberta. Registered midwives provide care for approximately 11% of birthing people and their babies in Alberta. And since 2009, the number of babies delivered by midwives in Alberta has significantly increased. I've also seen many jobs on Alberta Health Services for midwives, if you're thinking about where you work after. And midwives have also attended over 5,000 births in 2021. Now, important to note, which is why I am very, very drawn to Mount Royal University, is that if you have completed already post-secondary coursework, Mount Royal will assess your credit transfer when your application is received. You will also need to send them all your final and official post-secondary transcripts. And once these are assessed, you can determine or decide whether you'd like to transfer equivalent courses. Another amazing program in Canada is delivered by the University of British Columbia, and it delivers the only midwifery education program in British Columbia. It is delivered through the Department of Family Practice at UBC, and one of the entrance requirements is that you would have had to complete post-secondary courses before you begin year one of the program. These courses would need to be confirmed complete by official transcript received by the undergraduate admissions team no later than June 30th of the intake year. Specifically, Biology 151, which is Human Biology, Physiology, and Introductory Anatomy, or an approved equivalent, and this would be a 6-credit course, 3 in one semester and 3 in the other. And you would complete this over year one of the program. You would also need to complete a course in writing and research in the disciplines or an approved equivalent. So this is a 3-credit course. And it's important to note that any applicant who has previously completed a university degree will have this course prerequisite waived. So that's just amazing. We're going to talk about accelerated programs, and this is for people who they're either in nursing or another healthcare profession. They have their degrees and they also have relevant clinical experiences. The Toronto Metropolitan University offers a professional health degree midwifery education program, and this is a post-baccalaureate program that spans 2 years. And just some additional information on this program is that it is an accelerated stream for healthcare professionals. It requires that you have a baccalaureate degree in a healthcare profession, such as a Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and also significant maternity care experience. This post-baccalaureate program for healthcare professionals is offered to a limited number of suitable applicants annually, and they'll be identified during the review of the 4-year midwifery education program. This means that you would initially apply to the 4-year program. You would submit your detailed clinical and academic maternity care experience, and you will also be required to attend an interview. During the interview, they are going to assess your readiness for work, your work history, your readiness for midwifery specifically, and your ability to handle an intensive program. And so if you do get admissions and you are selected for an interview, prepare heavily for this interview. The post-baccalaureate healthcare professional degree, as I said, will span over 2 years, 6 consecutive semesters without summer breaks in between year one and year two. Applicants chosen for this degree will receive a conditional offer, and it will be based on you successfully submitting your midwifery education program application, your relevant experience. And when it comes to the specific healthcare professionals that it might be open to, it's not only nurses, but it can include international medical graduates, pharmacists, and physiotherapists. The University of British Columbia is the second program that you're able to complete your midwifery education in an accelerated manner. Registered nurses are able to complete their midwifery education through advanced placement plan. And just a huge shout out to the University of British Columbia for recognizing nurses by acknowledging our expertise and streamlining the process for midwifery registration. It's a great step towards honing our skills and experience, and just way to go, UBC. Now, the advanced placement plan enables registered nursing applicants to transfer up to 27 previously earned credits, thus reducing the cost and time required to complete the 143 credit Bachelor of Midwifery degree. This opportunity is limited to only registered nurses and nurse practitioners who are currently licensed in any Canadian jurisdiction. The applicant would need to complete the UBC Midwifery Supplemental Application, and I've added that link to this slide, and it's located on the program's website. They would need to submit this supplemental application to UBC Enrollment Services by the program deadline, and it's available on the website. You will also be required to make sure that your college transcripts, including your Bachelor of Nursing degree, is submitted. Now, if it is that you are offered admission, you would likely sit with that admissions officer and complete a plan of study, and it will be based on the courses that were transferable, your experience. It will really be tailored to you, and I feel like that's just very important to point out. Bridging programs for internationally educated midwives are available to people who were educated and practiced as midwives outside of Canada. There are a number of bridging programs that will help you towards getting your Canadian accreditation. Now, if you are an internationally educated midwife and your plan is to become registered in Canada, then I'd want you to start to think about certain certificates that you will be required to complete and to have. These include your neonatal resuscitation certificate, your cardiopulmonary resuscitation certificate, your emergency skills in obstetrics certificate, your fetal health surveillance certificate, and the opioid and benzodiazepine safe prescribing for a midwife. And this specific one is delivered through the University of British Columbia Continuing Professional Development Program. Now, the Toronto Metropolitan University has the International Midwifery Pre-Registration Program, and you'll be oriented to midwifery practice in Ontario. You'll also be able to complete your NRP, your ESW, your FHSL certificate in this program, and there will also be a 16-week clinical placement with a competency assessment at the end. You will also have the opportunity that if you're very qualified, that you'll be able to complete this 9-month program in 6 months instead. So there is an accelerated stream. And you'll also be prepared for the Canadian Midwifery Registration Examination. The next university is the University of British Columbia. If it is that you are an internationally educated nurse, and let's say you're looking to come to Canada, you will be able to apply to get a study co-op work permit. This program is also open to permanent residents, refugees, and Canadian citizens. You would have need to have seen a minimum of 100 births as primary midwife in the last 10 years. And this program is offered twice a year, and it is delivered in 3 terms. It's designed for midwives who have been educated in an approved midwifery program outside of Canada. Now, the Order of Midwives of Quebec provides midwifery training for midwives trained outside of Canada who are seeking recognition for their diploma or training in order to obtain a license to practice in Quebec. Now, they'll review your application, and there are 2 possibilities of either partial recognition or your application is just totally refused. If it is that it is approved, you will be able to get a personalized midwifery certificate, and it's reserved for midwives who have a recommended training from the Order of Midwives of Quebec. And this is specifically for graduates outside of Canada, France, and Switzerland. Now, if you're hoping to practice as a midwife in Canada and you are an internationally educated midwife, you would first need to apply to an independent qualification or education assessment service such as WES or IQAS to review your education documents. And then they would send it to the College of Midwives of Alberta. And there are costs that are associated with this. You would next need to complete the competency assessment tool and prior learning education assessment, and this will cost $1,500. You would also need to complete the Canadian Midwifery Registration Examination, and again, there are costs that are associated with this. You will also need to complete the Culture and Jurisprudence Examination, and you will need to complete the Objective Structured Clinical Examination, and this can cost up to $4,500. Once approved for registration, a new midwife will work with the College of Midwives of Alberta to find a supervision placement in Alberta. You will then join the Alberta Association of Midwives in order to obtain insurance. You will apply to the College of Midwives of Alberta for a practice permit. You will then need to apply for privileges through the Alberta Health Service and obtain a practice ID from Alberta Health. And you also need to apply for a job in Alberta, and you will find jobs for midwives on the Alberta Health Services website. There are other provinces and territories that do have different College of Midwives, and you'll be able to go on these colleges and find out, let's say you want to practice in Nova Scotia or New Brunswick or Northwest Territories. You would go on the website and find out how is it that you become a midwife in that province or territory if it is that you are already internationally educated. Next, we'll move on to community-based programs, Indigenous midwifery education. Now, the recognition and empowerment of midwives in Indigenous community is a crucial step towards addressing the historical under-recognition. It is vital to ensure that these communities have access to culturally sensitive and holistic care during pregnancy and childbirth. Empowering Indigenous midwives not only honors their traditional knowledge, but also promotes health outcomes and strengthens community resilience. Acknowledging that this program is exclusively for aspiring Indigenous midwifery students is a significant step towards fostering cultural continuity and addressing healthcare disparities. By prioritizing Indigenous representation in midwifery education, the program serves to identify the unique needs and perspectives of Indigenous communities while supporting and empowering leadership of Indigenous midwives. The Indigenous Midwifery Program is a pathway that supports the regeneration of strong Indigenous families by bringing birth closer to home. It restores emphasis on birth as normal rather than approaching it as an illness of treatment. Indigenous midwifery honors Indigenous peoples, languages, oral cultures, and traditions. The Health Professionals Act and the Midwifery Act include exemptions from Indigenous or traditional healers and midwives, which were established as part of broader self-governance initiatives in Ontario. This provision allows Indigenous midwives who provide traditional midwifery services within their communities to use the title Indigenous Midwife. Currently in Canada, there are three formal community-based training programs, and I'll talk about two of them. And these communities will set the standards for and oversee the practice of midwives, ensuring that the community has access to safe midwifery care. There are two community-based programs, and these are offered in three communities in Canada, across two provinces, so one in Ontario and in North Quebec. I actually could not find information on the midwifery program that is in Ontario, but I did find some information on the one in Northern Quebec. And I'll just read what it is that I did find on their website. And it's that the NCLEX Quebec Midwife Training Program is a formation based on learning by practicing in a clinical environment. The formation is completed with formations and learning modules. The student midwife provides pre, per, and postnatal care under the supervision of a senior midwife. This training program is officially recognized since 2008 by the Ministry of Health of Quebec and has also been acclaimed by numerous international organizations such as the International Confederation of Midwives, the World Health Organization, and the Canadian Society of Obstetricians and Gynecologists. At the end of the formation, the student midwife is recognized as competent by the College of Midwives of Quebec. To this day, two Inuit midwives are recognized to the Order of Midwives of Quebec, and another 10 students would complete their training in the next years. And that comes to the end of this video. I really hope that you did enjoy this video, you were motivated to apply for a program even if you need to move province. I hope you were well rejuvenated and inspired to take the leap, take the course, go for it. If it is that you do want to become a midwife in practice in Canada, it is possible. Begin the process today is my advice.